Dear students, today we will learn how the specifications of low-pass digital filter are given. We are going to consider here specifications of digital low-pass filter because by making use of low-pass digital filter transfer function, we can obtain any other filter transfer function. Let h of e raised to j omega is frequency response of IIR filter. Then absolute of h of e raised to j omega will become magnitude response of IIR filter. The magnitude response h of e raised to j omega of IIR filter will have a pass band transition band and stop band as we have seen previously. The specification of IIR filter can be expressed in any one of the following three different ways. It means that there are three ways of giving the specifications of IIR filter. And for design purpose, any one way may be used out of these three. Then which are those three ways? We will call these three ways as case 1, case 2 and case 3. Case 1 gain at passband and stop band edge frequency. So what may be given to us? Gain at passband, edge frequency, and gain at stopband, edge frequency may be given. Using these gains, we have to find the order of the filter, and then we have to find the transfer function of the filter. Case 2, instead of gain, attenuation may be given at passband and stopband edge frequency. We'll study these cases in detail very soon. Case 3. Ripple at passband and stopband edge frequency. Instead of giving gain and attenuation, ripple may be given at passband and stopband edge frequency. Now we will take case 1. Gain at passband and stop band edge frequency. The gain can be expressed either in normal or either in normal values or decibels, that is dB. Now you can see here the magnitude response graphs of a low pass filter. In the first figure, the gain is having here normal value. When the gain is given in normal values, the maximum gain value will be equal to 1, otherwise it will be less than 1. Omega P is passband edge frequency, omega S is stopband edge frequency. In the second figure, gain is given in decibels. You can see here dB is written. Omega P and omega S here also are the passband edge frequency and stopband edge frequency. AP is passband gain. AP is gain at passband edge frequency. AS is gain at stopband edge frequency. And the delta P is ripple. Delta P is ripple in the passband, because it is between AP and 1, because delta P is between 1 and AP. The maximum value of normalized gain is unity. This one you have just now seen in figure. And so the gain at other frequencies will be less than 1. Therefore, the dB gain will be negative. We know that log of 1 is 0, and if gain becomes less than unity, log of that value will become negative. Whatever we have seen in figure, those details now we will write. Let omega P equal to passband edge digital frequency in radians per sample. Omega S equal to stop band edge digital frequency, in radians per sample. All digital frequencies are to be measured in radians per sample. Whereas analog frequencies will be measured in hertz. Where AP is equal to magnitude at omega equal to omega P. Omega P means what? Passband edge distal frequency. Equal to gain or magnitude. At passband. Edge frequency. AS is equal to gain at omega equal to omega S. Omega S means what? It is stop band edge digital frequency. So you can write once again here, gain or magnitude at stop band edge frequency. APDB is equal to 20 times logarithm of magnitude of h of e raised to j omega at omega equal to omega p. So you can write this as gain in decibels or dB gain or dB magnitude at passband edge frequency. Similarly, we can write for ASDB. That is 20 log of magnitude of h of e raised to j omega at omega equal to omega s equal to dB gain or dB magnitude at stop band edge frequency. The gain in normal values can be converted to dB gain or vice versa. As below, passband edge frequency gain in dB is nothing but 20 log of AP. AP is here normal value. And normal value of gain, AP, may be obtained by using AP in decibels as AP equal to 10 to the power 20. Similarly, stop and edge frequency gain in decibels, that is ASdB, is equal to 20 log AS. And from ASdB we can obtain AS as 10 to the power AS in dB by 20. So these are conversions. Even we can take one example here for understanding purpose. See, these conversions are very, very important as far as the designing of filters are concerned. Let AP is equal to 0.8 and AS is equal to 0.2. These are the gains in normal values. Now we can convert these into decibel values. Now AP in decibels is equal to 20 log of AP, that is 20 log of 0.8, which turns out to be, if you use your calculator, calculate log of 0.8 and then multiply it with 20, you should get 1.9382 dB, which is nearly equal to, you can approximate it, minus 2 decibels. Similarly, stop and gain, similarly, gain at stop and edge frequency, AS in decibels, is equal to 20 log of AS, that is equal to 20 log of 0.2, which will be equal to minus 13.9794 dB. Rounding off, we get it as minus 14 dB. We can make use of minus 1.9382 dB and calculate AP, and we can make use of minus 13.9794 dB and calculate AS. Also, AP is equal to 10 to the power AP in dB divided by 20. That is equal to 10 to the power minus 1.9382 by 20 will be equal to 0.8. Similarly, AS is equal to 10 to the power AS in dB by 20. That is equal to 10 to the power minus 13. You have to take this value 9794 by 20. That would be equal to 0.2. So these are the two examples to understand how the conversions can be made between normal values of gain to gain in decibels and vice versa. Now we will take case 2. That is attenuation at pass band and stop band edge frequency. The specifications of IIR digital low pass filter may be given as attenuation at pass band and stop band edge frequency, where the attenuation, first we have to understand what is attenuation, right? Where the attenuation in a normal value is inverse of the gain at pass band and stop band edge frequencies. Pass band and stop band edge frequency. The attenuation is usually expressed in dB since the gain at edge frequencies are less than 1 or unity the attenuation in normal values will be greater than unity. And the decibel attenuation is positive. If attenuation becomes more than one, then in decibels its value will be positive. Let alpha p is equal to 1 by ap, that is equal to 1 upon h of e raised to j omega at omega equal to omega p. This is what? This is attenuation at pass band edge frequency. Alpha s is equal to 1 upon as, that is equal to 1 upon h of e raised to j omega magnitude at omega equal to omega s. This is attenuation at stop band edge frequency. Alpha p dB can be now calculated as 20 log of 1 by AP, which is also equal to 20 log of 1 upon magnitude of h of e raised to j omega at omega equal to omega p. Attenuation at passband edge frequency in dB, similar to that, alpha s dB is equal to 20 log of 1 upon as, that is equal to 20 log of 1 upon h of e raised to j omega at omega equal to equal to 20 log of 1 upon magnitude of h of e raised to j omega at omega equal to omega s. Attenuation at stop band. Edge frequency. In dB. Similar to conversion of gain in normal values into gain in decibels, we can convert attenuation in normal values into attenuation in decibels. The attenuation in normal values can be converted to dB attenuation or vice versa as below. Alpha p dB is equal to 20 log of alpha p, and alpha p is equal to 10 to the power alpha p in dB by 20. Alpha s dB may be obtained by alpha s as 20 log of alpha s. Alpha s equal to, that is normal value of attenuation may be obtained by using decibel value of alpha s as 10 to the power alpha s in dB by 20. Now we'll take one example based on this conversion. Let alpha p dB is equal to 1.9382 dB. That is equal to 2 dB. Alpha s dB is equal to 13.9794 dB, that is nearly equal to 14 dB. Now these dB attenuations can be converted into attenuations in normal values as follows. So let us write here attenuations in normal values are alpha p is equal to 10 to the power alpha p dB by 20 that is equal to 10 to the power 1.9382 divided by 20. On calculation, we get 1.25. And alpha s is equal to 10 to the power alpha s in dB by 20, that is equal to 10 to the power 13.9794 by 20, that is equal to 5. Now, using these alpha p and alpha s values, we can calculate AP and AS. Using these, attenuations, gains may be calculated as AP equal to 1 by alpha P, that is equal to 1 upon 1.25 equal to 0.8, and AS equal to 1 upon alpha S, that is equal to 1 by 5, that is equal to 0.2. Now we can draw the attenuation response and log attenuation response of a digital IIR low pass filter. Alpha S is attenuation at stop band edge frequency, and alpha P is attenuation at pass band edge frequency. So on this y-axis we will show attenuation equal to reciprocal of magnitude of h of e raised to j omega. It is attenuation versus omega, the values I am writing here are from our examples that we took. dB attenuation versus omega. Same thing we have to write for even previous problem also. Same thing we have to write for previous figure also. That is here in this figure. dB gain versus omega. This is for last figure. Now we will take case 3, that is ripple at pass band and stop band edge frequency. Sometimes the specifications are given in terms of ripples or tolerance. In the passband, and stop band. This ripple can be normal. This ripple can be in normal values or in decibel values. Let delta P is equal to passband ripple, delta S equal to stop band ripple, delta P in dB is equal to 20 log delta P. What is this? This is passband ripple in dB. Similarly, delta S dB is equal to 20 log delta S, that is equal to stop band ripple in dB. The dB ripples can be converted to normal values as below. Delta P is equal to 1 minus 10 to the power minus delta P in dB by 20. Similarly, delta S is equal to 10 to the power minus delta S in dB by 20. The ripples in normal values can be converted to gain or attenuation as below. AP is equal to 1 minus delta P and S is equal to delta S. Then what is relation between AP and alpha P? That is, the relation is alpha P is equal to 1 upon AP. Therefore, alpha P can be written as 1 by AP, which is equal to 1 minus delta P. Similarly, alpha S equal to 1 upon AS, but AS is equal to delta S. Therefore, we can write it equal to 1 by delta S. The ripples in dB can be converted into dB gain or dB attenuation as below. Please, while carrying out the conversions, you remember to make use of laws of logarithms. AP dB is equal to, by using this equation, 20 log of 1 minus delta P, that is equal to minus delta P dB. And AS dB is equal to 20 log of delta S, that is equal to minus delta S dB. I'll look at attenuations conversions using ripples. Alpha P dB is equal to delta P dB alpha S dB is equal to delta S dB. the ripples in dB can be converted to gain or attenuation in normal values. As below, AP is equal to 10 to the power minus delta P dB by 20, S is equal to 10 to the power minus delta S dB by 20, and alpha P is equal to 10 to the power delta P dB by 20 and alpha S equal to 10 to the power delta S dB by 20. Dear students, I will stop the class here and continue in next class with designing procedure of digital Butterworth filter. Thank you.